Hi ACPA, my name is Paul Richmond. I'm an artist in California, and I am so excited to be part of your reset day. I think I'm the perfect person for this job because I have pressed the reset button many, many times in my life. It was not that long ago when I was an awkward, confused, artistic teenager growing up in Columbus, Ohio. And I so wish that there had been an ACPA back then. I've been invited to share a little bit about my life today and hopefully inspire you. But before we do that, I want to say that you inspire me so much. I cannot imagine what it is like to be a teenager right now with all of the challenges and obstacles and things that you have to go through just to be able to go to school during this crazy time. It takes a tremendous amount of resilience, determination, creativity, and flexibility just to show up and continue learning in the midst of everything that's happening in the world right now. So I really want you to know that you do genuinely inspire me. Probably like a lot of you, when I was a little kid, all I wanted to do was make art. I would wake up every morning early before my parents, go down to the dining room table and just sit there and draw sometimes hundreds of drawings. Now, these were not masterpieces, but it showed how much I truly loved it. And I'm so grateful that my parents saw that. And even though they weren't artists themselves, they thought, we should probably do something to support this kid. And so they found an artist in our community named Linda Regula, who started teaching me private painting lessons just before my fourth birthday. Here's the very first painting that I made in her class. I don't know if you can tell who that is or not, but it's Mary Poppins. And so pretty soon my parents' house was filled with these giant oil paintings of Disney cartoons and characters from my favorite books and movies. Being an artist was something that I could take a lot of pride in. It was a really important part of my identity. And that became especially important as I entered middle school and started to discover other aspects of my identity that really made me feel very self-conscious. As a gay kid growing up in a small town in the 80s, I just didn't have any access to information that would tell me that who I was okay. And it was around the same time that I started to experience a lot of bullying at school. At that time, my biggest dream was to just be like everybody else. I wanted to blend in like wallpaper. But today, I am so grateful that that dream did not come true, because all of those things that made me feel so different are the same reasons that I have such a wonderful, happy, successful life today. I was still going to Linda's class every week, but she could tell something was wrong. And one evening at class, she asked me, "Are you okay? What's going on with you?" And I told her about how I was being bullied so badly at school and how I just felt like I didn't fit into this world. And she said, "Paul, you have to take all of those feelings and put them into a painting." So that's what I did. The very first painting that I ever made that really told my story is called The Piece That Doesn't Fit. I painted myself in this little tiny piece of the puzzle down at the bottom that does not fit in the space that's allotted for it. I was just such an outsider and it felt so bad. I can remember that. To this day, I can remember that feeling. Making a painting about it made such a difference. It took all of those feelings and gave them somewhere to go. And the really amazing part is that when other people saw the painting, especially other people that maybe had been through something similar, they understood it. It taught me that art is a powerful way to connect with other people. And connection to community is so important. So if you feel different, like I did, for whatever reason, there are so many different reasons why that might happen. I want you to know that you are not alone. There are people out there who care very much about you, and it is so important to reach out and connect with somebody who can help you get through that. It may feel even harder right now in this world that we're living in, where we're all socially distanced, but those people are still there. And many of them for you are at ACPA. So find those people, let them know what's going on with you, and allow them to help you. I had no idea what I wanted to do when I grew up besides being an artist, and I felt a lot of pressure to be successful. How in the world are you supposed to know as a teenager what you want to do with the rest of your life? I'm 40 years old and I still don't know what I want to do with the rest of my life. So I hope you give yourself permission to explore, have fun, try everything, and then see what fits. For me, because I knew I wanted to be an artist, that path led me to Columbus College of Art and Design. It was so great for me to start out as a student there because suddenly I wasn't the only weird artist in the room. I was surrounded by all these creative people who were all doing their own thing, and I found it to be so incredibly inspiring. When I was in college, I still didn't really know who I was. I hadn't come out of the closet yet, so I was just kind of like a sponge. I hadn't found my voice as an artist because it's really hard to make authentic art when you don't know who you are yet. But it wasn't until I graduated from college, came out, became comfortable with myself and my identity, that I was really able to start making artwork that expressed what I had to say. And I'll never forget, for that first year after I came out, I still hadn't told my parents yet. I was making these paintings that sort of dealt with that process of coming out and the feelings I was going through, but I never showed them to anybody because I didn't want my parents to see them, or people in my life that maybe didn't know yet. I didn't want them to find out by seeing a painting. So I literally, when I would finish those paintings and they would dry, I would take them off the stretchers, roll the canvas up, and ironically enough, put them in the closet. But that was okay for a while because those paintings were really for me. They were art therapy. They were a way for me to kind of just find my way through that process. And I want to encourage you to always use your creativity for yourself first. You don't have to share everything that you make on social media. You don't need to get feedback and approval. Just create art for the sake of creating art. But at the end of the year, my good friend Melissa was over one evening and she saw some of the paintings, and pretty soon, you know, she had me pulling them all out of the closet and unrolling them so she could take a look at them. And she said, "Paul, you have to start showing these." I started entering those paintings in some group shows and they got accepted. And I would go to the openings. I would have these amazing conversations with people at the art galleries, and they'd say, "How did you paint what I felt or what I went through?" That's what art can do. So I continued just painting my truth and trying to find every possible outlet to share it. I've illustrated over 400 book covers, most of them for works of queer fiction, because I think it's so important for everybody to be able to go to a library and find a book with characters like them. And I've had the opportunity to show and sell my artwork in galleries and museums all over the country, and I have collectors all around the globe. I've done commission paintings for James Franco, Troy Sivan, and Dolly Parton. Here I am, I'm reaching out to give you love that you're without. I can help you find what you've been searching for. So I am here to tell you that dreams can come true.
We're going to Dolly's house!
It takes a lot of work, and you're going to make a lot of missteps along the way. Today I live a wonderful, happy, creative life, but that does not mean that everything I touch turns to gold. I still make mistakes. I still try for things and get rejected a lot. That's just all a part of it. And I learn from those experiences too. One of the things that I'm proudest of is an organization I started back in 2011 with my childhood art teacher, Linda. The organization's called the You Will Rise Project. And our mission is to empower young people who have been affected by bullying to use their creative voices and express themselves. We do workshops, we've done exhibits in museums and art galleries all over the country. We do public art projects, murals, all designed to help people find their voice. So many people struggle to accept who they are. Maybe you can relate to that yourself, or maybe you know of somebody in your life, in your class, who just struggles. This project has taught me that there is a real power in helping people to find their voice and use it. Ever since the beginning of the pandemic, I have been doing a lot of teaching myself online, working with private students, groups of students on Zoom, and I have made some incredible connections with people of all ages, from kids to adults, that I've never met in person. So I know it's possible, but I also know it's not easy. It takes a lot of work. There are a lot of different obstacles that we didn't face when we were all together in a classroom. Your teachers care so much about you, and they want you to be successful. So on this reset day, push that reset button right now. Let go of any bad feelings that you might have had. Maybe you struggled last semester. Maybe there was a class or two where you just couldn't get things in on time, or you couldn't figure out the technology, or whatever the challenges might have been. That was then. Now we're starting a new chapter. Nothing is ever perfect. There are always challenges and obstacles. That's how we grow. When you struggle, don't go through it alone. There are people who care about you. Reach out to your teachers if you're having trouble understanding something. Reach out to your counselors if there's personal issues and stuff going on in your life that you need help with. Reach out to your friends. Nobody likes to admit that they're having a hard time. We just have to keep showing up, giving it our best, and growing. Along the way, do the things that feed your soul. Creativity is such a powerful tool. Keep a sketchbook, sing a song, do whatever allows you to express yourself just for fun. Take care of your mind, your body. I've been going on so many walks, doing yoga, meditation, just trying to stay sane. Do whatever it takes so that you take care of yourself, because you have a lot of important work to do. Your creative voice can change the world. Thank you all so much for allowing me to be part of your reset day. I hope that you have an awesome year. Take care of yourself. Take care of each other. Bye-bye.